Today, I will introduce a new video replacement model called Mocha. The biggest feature of this model is that it does not require structured guidance. Simply put, you do not need to perform a masking process across the entire video. We can complete the video character replacement using only the first frame and a mask. Therefore, compared to models like Animate, it is more flexible. Of course, looking at the examples on the official website, we can see that it has certain characteristics. First, it performs quite well in replacing cartoon characters. Furthermore, there are no issues with real characters. However, in my testing, I feel that its performance in replacing real characters is still slightly inferior compared to Animate. Additionally, it handles lighting and shading very accurately. This is a capability that Animate completely lacks. Speaking of which, I want to share something very interesting. I actually have a certain connection with the Mocha model. This is because when I was conducting a review of Animate, a fan left me a comment. He said they were developing a character replacement model and had seen one of my lighting test examples, the one where a light bulb rotated around an elderly person in a dimly lit room. They felt that this example could very well reflect some of the lighting characteristics of their model, and they asked if they could use it. Of course, I replied that they could. Consequently, we can see that specific case here, and my subtitle is still preserved within it. So, when I saw this, I figured the model they were referring to must be Mocha. But I must clarify here, this video was not made by me. It is testing material that I collected from the internet. So I must make this clarification. In addition, it also showcased some of its features regarding action precision and comparisons with other applications. Currently, Kijai has added support for this model. Therefore, it is relatively simple for us to use this within ComfUI. We can open the example workflows. There are mainly two example Mocha workflows, one implemented using the native model, and the second is a workflow implemented using the model created by Kijai. Today, our primary focus will be on the second one. Regarding model downloads, you can go to Kijai and find a folder called Mocha in the Hugging Face model list. After clicking on it, you will see the main Mocha model. I have also built this workflow on Running Hub. Everyone can access this platform via runninghub.ai. In the realm of ComfUI, Running Hub is an excellent online workbench because it follows up immediately as soon as new technologies and new models appear. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which grants 1,000 free points. Furthermore, you receive 100 bonus points every day you log into Running Hub, allowing you to try your own workflows for free. All right, next, let's look at the basic structure of this workflow. To make its structure clearer, I refactored it, but the basic process remains unchanged. The first section is the main model loading part. For the main model, we are using the version of the Mocha model released by Kijai, not the one provided by the official source. Additionally, we added an acceleration LoRa. This is our VAE. At the same time, this model requires more VRAM resources, so we must enable block swapping. Moreover, the setting for the number of swap blocks must be large enough. Kijai suggests 40. Next is the data processing section. First is the reference video. I have a video here of an Asian beauty holding a samurai sword and performing a very cool action. We resize it below this. We extract the first frame. As we mentioned earlier, the difference between Mocha and Animate is that Mocha uses non-structured guidance. This means we only need to provide a mask for the first frame. The way we obtain the mask is the same as with Animate. Here we use a point editor to select the desired subject using green points and exclude unwanted content using red points. Then we use the SAM2 segmentation node to obtain our mask. We also performed an expansion on this mask, but the setting is relatively small, currently 5 pixels, and thus we get the mask for the first frame. Next is our reference image. Everyone should try to select it based on the perspective of the original video. What does this mean? For example, if the character in my current video is shown from the waist up, a half-body perspective, the reference image we select should ideally contain all content from the waist up. We need to expand it to align with our target resolution. For example, here I set it to 832 by 480. I will use the pad method to expand it to the corresponding resolution. When using the reference image, it was mentioned that the image should preferably have a clean background. Therefore, we used the remove background function here and filled it with a neutral gray. Therefore, at the background node, everyone must select color. Do not choose alpha. The color value should be set to 7F, 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 which is equivalent to 127, 127, 127. The final image everyone gets looks like this. Next is the sampling section. The commonly used part follows Kijai's established process. Crucially, we need to form an image embedding, which is the image vector. Here we use the VAE, our input image, our mask, and our first reference image to generate an image embedded. During sampling, there are no specific requirements for our prompt, so I chose an empty prompt here. I selected 5 steps for sampling, and the algorithm used here is DPMISD. Let's look at the generated result. Overall, the effect is decent. However, you will notice that the degree of realism is not as good as one animate. Although the effect is still decent, if you compare closely, you will find that the overall realism and the integration of the character with the background feel slightly worse. We will see corresponding content when we look at other examples later. That was the first and most basic workflow. The second workflow involves replacement within a multi-character scene. Here I have a target video of 2 characters walking in the desert. I will replace the character on the left with this beauty. So, the basic process is still the same. Let's look directly at the generated result. Now let's talk again about its integration effect with real characters. It is not as good as one animate. You might feel that this character doesn't look fully photorealistic, right? However, you will find one thing here that one animate lacks: the shading and lighting. Notice the shadow of the hair on the character's body, the lighting on the arm, and the lighting on the face. You'll find this is excellent. You can look back at my review of one animate, specifically the example where the light bulb rotated around the elderly person. After replacement, the lighting effects were completely lost. Through this example, you will find that Mocha's ability to handle lighting is indeed unmatched by other models. Alright, next, let's continue looking at an advanced usage. You might have noticed that it actually has 2 references. Besides our reference character, there's a second one. What is the second reference? There's a note here stating that the second one is optional. When do you use it? If your perspective is relatively far and you cannot clearly present the character's face, then you can use a facial close-up image to enhance facial consistency. So we know how to do this. The processing procedure for reference 2 is exactly the same as for reference 1. The only difference is regarding the reference image. For this, I will focus more on a facial close-up. Therefore, we can connect both reference images to the Mocha embed node, and we can achieve the same function. Actually, this feature is a bit redundant, because if the pixel count is insufficient, the facial presentation generally won't be very good. In this example, you will find that whether I add reference 2 or not, the effect is similar. Therefore, it is mostly used in scenarios where the face is relatively small. Let's look at this one, an Asian beauty walking in the rain holding an umbrella. Here, we are mainly testing the motion and facial details. Let's look directly at the generated result. We will notice a white border on the character's outer silhouette. Therefore, the overall feel is that the character and background integration is not as good as one animate. Of course, it is unclear whether this is an issue with the original model or Kijai's implementation. But this is the current situation we observe. However, you will find that the overall motion performance is still excellent. Finally, I want to test a flaw that all video replacement models have. Look at my original video, it's an anime beauty performing a highly difficult action, a high kick. What happens here? Usually, when a leg is raised to this angle, many models mistakenly identify it as an arm hand. This flaw is not limited to video replacement models. Video generation models and text-to-image models also share this shortcoming, because in the majority of training datasets, at this angle, it should be an arm hand, not a leg. Let's look at the generated result. It cannot avoid the common flaw. This model still recognized it as an arm hand, resulting in a very strange shape. This concludes my comprehensive test of the Mocha model. I hope that when you use it, you can capitalize on its strengths and avoid its weaknesses. Okay, that's all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.